Hi, this is Garnet Campbell, and you're about to see some images, you're about to hear some interviews from a place called Kitamaat, British Columbia. My friend Micah Borosovich and I went up to visit some young people from the Haisla Nation there, and some of this is some of their story.
My name is Jennifer Bolton. I lived here in Kitamaat Village for about 13 years. I was born in Prince Rupert, BC. In the summertime, I like to hang out with friends, go swimming at the river and the bay and everything. But I hate doing chores. Is that so wrong?
I don't think so.
So I have to escape from the house. I do anything to get away from the vacuum, because the vacuum's evil.
The vacuum is evil.
Yeah.
Does it ever attack you?
Yeah. The part that sucks up your toes. I tell them that I want to go somewhere. I don't know. To get away, I jumped out my window a couple times. I hurt my foot, but I wasn't injured. Seriously. I was gay, though.
Why?
Because I'm not good at interviews. I'm not good at talking to gay people.
We're talking to a young guy. What's your name?
Callum. I live here, but I was born in Vancouver. I like playing basketball. The funniest thing that I ever saw is probably this girl named Camille 2 days ago. She was trying to run down this hill and it was real slippery and she fell and she had this white jacket on. She got it all, white sweater and she got it all muddy and everything.
My name is Penny. I lived here all my life and I like to do a lot of stuff like play basketball and hang around friends and go online and try not to miss in. Okay, I'm standing beside this totem pole which represents the story about these three young boys who were trying to cook a fish and this frog came up and disturbed them. So the three young boys threw the frog away. And after that, the frog came back, and the boys got tired of it and threw in the fire. And then the frog just blew up all over their fish, which got them really mad and frustrated because that ruined their supper.
Hi, my name is Dwayne Stewart. I live here, I've lived here in Kitamaat Village for 9 years. In the summertime, I like to hang out with my friends, go to camps, and just do whatever I want. Now the totem pole that you see behind me has a story to it. The frog started to bloat up and exploded and got all over their fish. The boys were angry at this because the frog had just ruined their lunch. As the boys were leaving, an old lady came up to where the frog was thrown into the fire, and he heard her say, "Why, oh why did you do this to my son?" Then she cursed them, saying that one by one the boys will die and that their village will burn down. So as the boys were leaving, they start to canoe. They got into their canoe and start paddling downstream. Few minutes after they left, they came to one point where one boy just collapsed and died. Then a few minutes later, a second boy died. Then the third boy got to the village and told his people that their village was going to burn down. After he said that, on each side of the village, it started to burst into flames. And then the chief of the village grabbed his daughter and threw her into a safe hole, gave her some water and food to survive. Before he left, he put his shields over the hole in a little hole there just so she can breathe. 2 days after their village burnt down, she came out and seen the old lady in the top hat. And when she seen the old lady, the girl noticed that the old lady had a staff which represents the pole that she see. Then later, there is a group of people that did a peace treaty between the Haida people and the Haisla people. They adopted the girl and they used the pole just to show that, about the peace treaty between the Haida people and the Haisla people. The end.
My name is Dana. I've lived here in Kitamaat all my life and I enjoy playing basketball a lot. There's a lot of guys that play too, like the junior boys and the senior men, and Chris is one of them. He gets really frustrated when the gym isn't open and when he can never hit the ball. Half the time he does get the ball, but I'll play him and I'll win.
How bad, baby?
Probably a close game.
Come on, you said before you kicked it. What?
Yes.
What are these images that are happening right now at the basketball game between you and him?
Yes, he's trying to block me out, but I got by him and I caught a shot.
Yeah, it looks like more than a shot. It looks like a total dunk.
Yes. Yes, I'm after it.
So how'd you learn how to jump that high?
The coach.
He teaches you how to jump?
Yes, he teaches us how to do everything.
That's a pretty high jump.
Yes.
Grabbing the rim like that.
Yeah.
Are all the basketball players here in, the Haisla village able to do such vertical damage like that?
Most of them.
I look at Chris here, totally dangling off the rim after smashing him down.
That was pretty cool, I guess. Well, this demon that she dealt with, few and far between, from
beauty and the beast to a perfect combination. My name is Kirsten. I've lived here in Kitamaat all my life, and in my spare time, I like to go to the gym, shoot around, play basketball, and hang out with friends. I would say some of the problems we'd have to deal with relationships. For example, if one girl liked a guy and another girl liked the same guy, they would probably end up fighting. Seriously fighting and actually hurting one another. And that's one of the problems we're looking for a solution.
Hospital. In the summertime, I like to play basketball, go swimming at the river and at the bay. Young people's dreams are important and the future is bright, but there are obstacles to overcome. One of those obstacles is drug use.
People can't just quit.
It's not as easy because
they want to quit, but it's addicting, so they can't.
Yeah.
They can't just say, I'm going to quit right now because it's addicting.
And as you said, if you think about the negatives of what it could do, and then if you stop, you could think about what life would be if you actually didn't do it. You'd be going to college, university, being a doctor, a lawyer. Some people really need help when they try to stop.
Looking for solutions to overcome these obstacles.
There are ways to help stop.
Hi, this is Garnet. Once again, to just wrap up this short media presentation. One of the interesting things that I saw, especially through the story about the totem pole, I saw a chief there who had wisdom to not only see the problem, what was happening in his village, but the wisdom to take action to help and save the ones that he loved, his daughter. Now, here we are, you know, hundreds of years later, we're in a community where there is, you know, real problems. And the young people here have the wisdom to be able to recognize what those problems are. But not just that, but they've got, you know, some bravery to actually take action to help save their friends that they love, and in reaching out to them in practical ways. So all in all, it was an incredible trip. We made so many good friends up here, and hope to get back there sometime.